Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how I can build my simple stack size sorter, which you can see right in front of you. Many of you might know this little contraption here, which sorts items depending on whether they are stackable or not, with the non-stackable items landing in the bottom chest here and the stackable items landing in this chest here. The top here is of course our input. This has been around for quite some time. But there are actually three different stack sizes for items, which is 1, 64, and in between we have 16 as a stack size. And this little contraption I came up with right here can actually determine all three and sort the corresponding items into the different chests right here. So as a little example, I have prepared a few of those in this chest here, and if I unlock the entire thing, you will see it starting to sort. And after running its course, we now have the non-stackable items inside of this chest here, and one is actually for the moment trapped inside of this hopper there. Then we have the stack size 16 inside of this chest, and the stack size 64 in this chest right there. So now, how does this thing work? Basically, we have three stages. A stage that separates the item stream, then a stage that determines the stack size, and finally a stage that determines which output is actually used, or into which output the items actually flow. So now how do those stages work? The first stage is rather straightforward. When an item is inside of this hopper here, it's detected, the hopper before it is blocked, and the hopper after it is unblocked for a moment. The reason here is that we have to slow down the item stream inside of this hopper here, and at the same time we have to keep those 20 items inside of this hopper for the entire thing to work properly. That also means that we don't have the maximum amount of items we can get through this hopper pipeline, so it's pretty much half the amount of items I can get through at a time. Anyway, that's the separator. The second stage works with those 20 items inside of the hopper plus whatever item we are checking for the moment. If the new item is a stack size 64, the output remains at 1. If it's an item with a stack size of 16, the output is increased to 2, and if it's non-stackable, the output is increased to 3. And that way we can determine the actual stack size. The reason we had to slow down the item while it's traveling through here, and thus also the reason for the separation at the beginning, has to do with the way that the comparators detect. So a comparator which detects whether an item is in there or no item is in there, which is the case for the first stage, can do that while the item is just traveling through. But apparently it does not detect at the same speed whether the signal strength is 1, 2 or 3. So if I were to time it just at the maximum amount of maximum speed for items to travel through, this comparator here, or this output, would stay at 1 independently whether it should actually be 2 or 3. And that's the reason for the entire thing to slow down a bit. Anyway, the last stage is pretty straightforward. It simply detects whether the signal strength is 2 or 3 and then correspondingly unlocks the hoppers at the bottom there. So anyway, that's a straightforward explanation of how the thing works. Now let's talk about the size. So as you can see here, it's a total of 6 blocks long. It's 4 blocks wide or deep and also 4 blocks high. So quite a bit bigger than this simple contraption back there, but I wasn't able to actually compact it anymore. And with that said, let's get to the resources. So of course you're gonna need some building blocks, then 7 redstone dust, 3 redstone torches, 4 repeaters, 2 comparators, 8 hoppers, a lever or button to redirect some wire, and then 20 renamed items, which is pretty much all you're gonna need. And with that said, let's quickly show you how to build this sorter here. Okay, so the starting point is a hopper pipeline of 6 hoppers with 2 Further hoppers below the last two ones, which leads us to three distinct outputs for the non-stackable 16 stack size and 64 stack size items. And then we have an input here represented by this chest where the items go into the system. Then let's start with the wiring. For that, let's start diagonally to this first hopper here in the line. Then we go down and up again. Put a repeater on three ticks in this gap, redstone dust on top of those two blocks. Then a block hovering above here with a lever below it, which should redirect the wire. Then we need a block here with some redstone dust on top, block on top to cut off that wire. Then lowered block and raised block. This time a comparator in this gap. Next we need a block right next to the wire down there with a torch below this hopper here. Then a comparator on top of it with a block raised there. Then block to this side and one block down here. Then we place two more blocks like that. In this gap we place a repeater on four ticks with a torch to this side. Then three redstone dust down like that. Next, let's go and first place a block here with a repeater on four ticks running into a full block with a full block below it, torch on the side of this block. Then a block diagonally here with some redstone dust on top. And then finally a block here with a repeater on three ticks. And that's the wiring done. And the last part is filling in 20 renamed items inside of this hopper here on the red side. And that's the entire thing done. And that was how you can build this rather simple stack size sorter here. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and well, see ya!